Hi there, my name is Santiago and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today, we're gonna be talking about mistakes that I made while I applied to medical school, mistakes that were in my MCAS application. It's officially March, so that means that many of you are getting ready to apply to medical school. Because I've already gone through the process and in retrospect, I can see how I could have done things better, I decided that today we're gonna set some time aside to specifically discuss 5 mistakes that I made and really things you should avoid while you apply to medical school this cycle. As always, if you like my videos, please subscribe. If you're new here, give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment down below. Doing all of those things increases my engagement and shows the YouTube algorithm that people are watching my videos, that people are enjoying the content that I'm making, and it allows me to reach other people out there, newer audiences that I might not have been able to reach without you doing those things. So please, if you like it, please consider giving me a thumbs up down below. All right, let's get started. So my first tip for you is to write your secondaries early. This was something that I was told by pre-meds ahead of me, and I just didn't listen. I consider myself a pretty good writer, so I figured, you know, yeah, I'm applying to 20 schools, but whenever I get the secondary sent my way, I'll just work through them there, I'll get inspired, I'll feel this rush of deadlines, and I'll just get everything done when it comes my way. Big mistake. A lot of schools had at least 3 secondary essays for you to write, but they also could go much higher than that. I think one school had, 9 questions. No, 2 schools had around 9 to 11 questions, essays for me to write. Now, I do like writing, but to do all of that for one school and then to do it again for 20 schools, it becomes a lot. So that's why my number one mistake was not doing my secondaries early. You can really just Google, like UCLA School of Medicine secondary questions, and you'll have your essay prompts ready to go, and you can already start working on those now and not wait till the last minute like I did. Doing this will ensure that you submit your application quick, fast, and be one of the first applications that's reviewed, and it'll increase your chances of getting admitted to that medical school because you're not competing for limited space, but in the beginning when there's a lot of slots for medical school applicants to fill. All right, so my second tip for you is to not sell yourself short. Allow yourself to reach to certain schools. Give yourself that liberty. This was a big mistake that I did to myself because I limited myself without necessarily needing to. I did apply to 20 schools, and all 20 schools were schools that I ultimately saw myself competitive enough to get admitted. It's cool and all, I found schools that are great for me, schools that I'm really excited that I got accepted to. However, I never really allowed myself the opportunity to interview with these other schools that might be considered top tier or out of my MCAT and GPA levels. The reason I'm specifically bringing this up is because I ended up getting 2 emails from Harvard, Yale. Actually, I think I got another one from another top tier school, basically saying that they saw my MCAT and they told me that I would have been a competitive applicant in their school, in their application cycle. They told me to consider applying to medical school next year. And yeah, I guess if I had applied to their schools, maybe I would have been a competitive applicant, and maybe I would have liked to learn more about the schools and just to go through the interview process and orientation day, just to learn more about the schools to see what their programs are really about. So if you have the opportunity to apply to multiple schools, I would consider applying to 1 or 2 schools that are outside of your average MCAT and GPA scores, but schools that ultimately you would be interested in. You never know, you might get accepted. Then my third tip is to have your MCAT score ready as soon as possible. I applied during COVID, and ultimately what happened to me was because of the national lockdowns that we had, my MCAT ended up being canceled and I didn't get it rescheduled until a date in which, basically, I didn't take it in time to send my application with an MCAT score. What this meant was that schools got my application and were ready to move to the next steps with me, but because I didn't have an MCAT score, they were unable to offer me a secondary right away or to really start looking at my application comprehensively because there was no MCAT score. Something might occur in your life where you aren't able to take the MCAT where you're in the date that you originally thought, and this might just affect your application overall because you might have to send your application without an MCAT score. That's why I'm suggesting that you have your MCAT score as soon as possible. Ideally, if you can take it the winter break before the summer that you apply, then you have 6 months to have that score already sitting. You have, you know, just that liberty that if something does happen in winter break, maybe you can take it again in February or March, just earlier than I had anticipated when I had scheduled it in May, I believe. All right, tip number four, avoid back-to-back interviews or avoid back-to-back big events if you can. During my application cycle, I ended up having two back-to-back interviews with two different schools Monday through Wednesday. And really, I started preparing for my interviews that Sunday. So it was a 4-day event. And by Tuesday, by Wednesday, I was exhausted. This ultimately affected me because I just wasn't fully there on that Tuesday and definitely was not there on that Wednesday because I had just gotten so exhausted by the process, gotten so exhausted by trying to sell the best version of myself to these people that I was meeting, both in terms of the other applicants that were there and the faculty and staff that I was meeting. So whenever you're going through the application cycle, if you have big events happening, you know, maybe marriages or just big events for you to attend, research presentations and then interviews or just exams if you're still in school, just make sure you're spacing everything out in a way that makes sense for the timeline. All right, last thing, allow yourself the liberty to have fun. This is something that I kind of learned to do as I went through the application cycle. By my fourth or fifth interview, I just let myself have fun. Like, I showed up professional and ready for the interview day, ready for orientation and everything else that presented itself to me. But I felt myself so casual. I felt myself so relaxed and non-anxious because by then I had let myself have fun. I didn't take myself too seriously. I didn't take this day too seriously. And what I mean by that is I didn't go into it thinking, oh my God, I'm an applicant. I thought it more, I had the opportunity to talk to someone from the school about why I should be a doctor and why their school would be a good fit for me. And I guess seeing it through that lens just allowed me, again, to have that casual, non-stressed presence about myself. This let me interview better. It let me absorb information about the schools better. And really, it just allowed me to leave that interview day feeling confident and ready to go onto other interviews and to just this waiting process of waiting to hear back from schools about whether I got accepted or rejected. So yeah, let yourself have fun. It is a serious, you know, time of your life, but it should also be a fun one. If you're lucky enough to get an interview, it's because the school likes you. They already read your application. Now they just want to connect your face and your persona to those words on paper to make sure that everything mashes together. All right, those are the five biggest mistakes that I had in my MCAS application that I think you should avoid and can avoid if you just pay attention to these things right now before you submit your application here soon. Again, if you like this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up, subscribing, sharing it with others. I'm really trying to increase my engagement here before I start medical school in the summer. And yeah, I would just really appreciate your help in doing that. As always, take care, get vaccinated whenever that becomes available to you, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Adios.